Hello, hello, mic test. Percent profitability is 88.7%, which is good. The net profit is amazing, 301 trades. Profit factor is also very good. The average trade is also amazing, which is 0.77%. I think, yeah, we can say that it's a good strategy. Hello financial programmers, I'm Pritvik Dashora and I'm back with a new video and some new learnings. This is the third video of this playlist on making trading strategies on Pine Script. In the first video, we talked about tilted RSI trading strategy, which is basically RSI divergence trading strategy. In the second one, we built a strategy on Bollinger Bands and it is called Drift Bollinger Bands trading strategy. And now if you're looking for making a Pine Script for grid trading strategy, then in that case, you're at the right place. If you're new to my YouTube channel, guys, on this channel, I make videos related to trading bots, implementation of AI in finance, making trading strategies on Pine Script and using some highly valuable finance APIs, etc., etc. So if this is something you are interested in, then you should click on the subscribe button and also hit on the bell icon because there is a lot of good material that is going to be covered on this YouTube channel very soon. And I don't want you guys to miss out on anything. It's free of cost and very, very valuable for me. So just give me that subscribe button, guys. These are the topics that we are going to cover today. So we are building the grid trading strategy on Pine Script. The three steps that we are going to follow here are the first one is creating the grid lines using moving average, simple moving average. The second one is we'll create entry and exit positions. And the third thing is that we will plot everything for a better visual representation. For the people who don't know what is grid trading strategy, basically we split our orders into multiple parts, right? Such that we try to average out the entry or the exit price, right? For example, this is the graph, right? And I want to take some long and short positions. Then I will not take 100% long or 100% short positions. Rather than that, I will split those long and short positions into multiple parts, right? There are 9 grids in this example. What it will do is basically it will split the total amount in 9 equal parts, and whenever any condition gets triggered, then in that case it will place an equivalent buy or sell order. For example, in this case the share price went down from this point to this point, it went down a bit more, right? So it has bought. As it is going down, it is buying, and then it is buying again, it is buying again, and then here as well. So the average buy price is actually much lower than the first buy price. That's the main idea. And whenever there is a bit increase in the price, it is selling it, right? So there's a very good possibility that overall trade will be in a positive side, although there will be some, I would say individual trades might be in negative side, but the overall trade would be in the positive direction. And you can see here as well, exactly the same thing happening. So now what we are doing here is basically our lines are not going to be straight lines. Our lines will be moving average lines, right? The center line will be the actual moving average, and the uppermost line would be some n standard deviation above the original moving average line. The lowermost line would be n standard deviation below the actual moving average line. So that's the main idea. And then there will be grids which will be evenly spaced between these three lines, and whenever it crosses one of the grids, it will buy or sell on the basis of that. So in our case, what we will do, for example, in this case the prices are going down, right? So it crossed this particular line and it bought some amount of shares, right? Then it crossed it another moving average line, and then it bought it like more shares again. So whenever all these things are happening, and when it goes back, when the prices like go up again, then this particular amount will be sold when the price crosses one moving average line which is above the one that was considered while buying. So in this case, for example, this one was considered for buying, then this one will be considered for selling. Suppose in this case the third red line from the bottom was considered to buy this particular position, and the fourth red line from the bottom will be considered to sell, right, whenever it crosses. So that's the main idea, simple, very simple logic, and this is something that we are going to replicate on Pine Script code, and let's see what are the results. But yeah, before that, you'll find many videos where people are quoting that they get 100% win rate. There's a big catch, guys. There is nothing in this world which will give you 100% accuracy. Definitely there are some limitations of all the strategies. Again, this is not an investment advice advice, I would say, from my side. That's just made for educational purpose. But apart from this, there's another point. People who are quoting it to be 100% are absolutely wrong, because it will only work if the prices are moving in this particular range. If it goes above and it never comes back, then in that case, this is not going to happen. So anyways, let's write this entire logic in our Pine Script code and let's see what is the result. Coming to the code, we will start with version 5 and then strategy. And then inside this, I have provided the title to be grid trading strategy. OLA is equal to true because I want to plot my my close price and other things on the main plot. Pyramiding is equal to 14 because we are going to have multiple buy and sell orders. So that's why we'll have to provide some number for pyramiding. I have given 14 as a number for pyramiding. Closed entries rule is equal to any, and initial capital is equal to 1000. So we'll start with $1000. And before writing the next thing, yeah, let's keep the interval interval of candlesticks to be 15 minutes. And I am doing the entire analysis on US 100, which is basically NASDAQ 100, right? So the second thing which is required is the input, right? So I will comment it like this. And let's start with the first one, which is MA length, right? Which is basically the length of the moving average. So because it's a length, it is an integer. So input dot integer default value, which is, let's just take some big number, suppose 300, right? Now the title is moving or MA length. Let's create a group inside the input box. I'll show you, show it to you in just 1 minute, which is moving average conditions. And then step is equal to, let's keep 10 here, right? So it will increase or decrease by 10 units, right? That's the first thing. Second thing is standard deviation. We have to provide the uppermost and the lowermost bound, right? So input dot, this one is float, right? And I have provided 0.03, which is basically 3%. The title is upper and lower grid deviation. Group is grid conditions, and step, it will increase or decrease by 0.01. So the next input is the number of grids that we will have in our strategy, which is input dot int. Let's keep 15 as default, and let's again keep the max value to be 15 only. You can keep a different number of grid lines here, but I'm just keeping it 15. The title is grid line quantity and the group is grid conditions only. So this will be a part of just one group, right? So let me just do one thing. Let me plot lows here and let's see how the inputs look like. When I save it, it asks me to save it. So let me just do it, grid trading strategy video. And when I save it and add it to chart, perfect. So you can see that these are the inputs. It looks like this. So the ML length, right? It's a part of moving average conditions group. Then grid conditions, there's another group, and these are the two inputs which are part of that group. Perfect. I think I should zoom it a bit. It works better, right? Perfect. Now let's calculate moving average. Simple moving average, which is MA is equal to TA dot SMA close comma MA length. Now upper bound, simple logic, which is MA, as I mentioned, MA multiply by 1 plus STD. And then the same goes with lower bound as well, right? Now what's the width of the grid? So grid width is equal to upper bound minus lower bound divided by grids minus 1, right? It should be grid. Well, let me just do it like this. Grids minus 1, right? Simple maths logic. Now in order to make the grids, I will have to introduce an array here. If you guys don't know what is an array, then you should check out my video on NumPy. Over there I have actually talked about a lot of functionalities on NumPy library and how to use array functionality of NumPy. Anyways, it's something similar here as well. So what I'm gonna do here is grid array is equal to array dot new float, right? So basically we have created an array and there is no, like, nothing saved right now. It's just an empty array. Now I've written a basic for loop here. Basically for I is equal to 0 to grids minus 1, right? And the step is basically 1. What we are going to do here is we will push, right, this one, which is lower bound plus grid multiply by I, into the grid array. Now what is happening here? Basically array dot push is something like append in Python, right? So basically we are appending different things in this particular array to increase this array. In the beginning we had nothing, it was an empty array. If you want to like make the grids from the lower bound, then what we have to do is we'll have to add grid width, which is the width that we calculated here, multiply by I, right? So in the first iteration, I's value is equal to 0, so this will be 0, right? So the first line of this array is basically lower bound itself. The second one is grid width multiply by 1, right? So this is the first, this is the second line, and the third line, and the so on, right? So this is how we will create the entire grid from the lower bound to the upper bound. We could do the similar thing using the upper bound as well. So it would be upper bound minus grid width multiply by I. Now, I have introduced another array, which is order array, right? Which is array dot new bool, right? In this case, it was new float. It is new bool. And the size of this array is basically the size of grids, right? In this case, for example, 15, right? And all the values inside this are false. So basically, I'm creating a Boolean array which will have false for all the values. Now, why I'm making this particular array is basically I will change the values inside it according to the orders that we'll be placing. So let me come to this particular chart. So for example, if you start from the bottom, say this is number 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on, right? So if the first order is getting placed here, so the fourth line is actually responsible for a by condition, right? In this particular array, for example, if all the lines were allocated false in the beginning, we will convert this false to true such that we get to know that this particular line is responsible for first by condition and so on, right? So that's the main idea of this order array. I'll show you in just 1 minute how I will be changing the values inside this particular array. Before adding the entry and the close conditions, guys, I have a very important information to share with you. Recently, I launched a course on Python for financial programming, and the link for this is in the description box, which is fpritvik.com/python. Just click on one of these. It will open this website and you can see that these are the different pointers for this particular course. There are 5 sessions, 10 chapters, 22 videos, 10 quizzes, 3 assignments, 2 live projects, Telegram community access, and a lot more things, right? These are the 2 projects that I talked about in this particular course, and this is the entire syllabus. I highly recommend you guys to at least check it out, and it's very affordable. If you are interested to learn Python for financial programming or Python for finance from scratch, then this is something that I think you should be interested in. So just click on the link, and if you use the code RTK40, you'll get an instant 40% discount on this particular course, which is valid for a very, very limited time period. So yes, check it out, this course, and let's come back to our code. So now let's make the entry conditions. I'll have to make another for loop here for I is equal to 0 to grids minus 1 by 1, right? Which is the same for loop that we created here. Now here we'll have to check if the close price is less than this particular line, right? This is how we'll be checking if there is any trade that has placed or not. So I'll have to make if condition here. If close is less than array.get, basically I'm referring to like one particular index inside the array, which is like this one. So I'm referring to the grid array which we have created here, and I is the index, right? In Python we used to use a square bracket, right? It's just the similar things. Here we are using array.get, right? And not array.get order array I. It means that the close price is less than this particular index, and we have no orders placed in the past, right? That's why I'm putting it a not here. It should be false, right? Then in that case, let's just create a by ID to be I, right? Which will be 0 in the beginning, the first iteration. It will change basis on the different iterations that we are taking here. Again, we will change the array, which is array set order array. As I mentioned, if in the beginning I am gonna change this particular array here, in the beginning it was all false, now it will have to be changed to true. The position of the index is basically order ID, right? And the first one, it would be 0 and so on. It will be changed to true. Now we'll have to place the order, which is quite simple. I think you guys already know it. Strategy.entry. The ID is basically the string of this particular by ID, because it doesn't consider the integers. I is integer in this case. We'll have to convert it to into string. The direction is basically strategy.long. Quantity is, this is very important, guys. Strategy.initial capital divided by grids minus 1. Why? As I mentioned in the PPT that I was showing, we have to split the total amount into the number of grids that we have, such that if all the lines have buy or sell orders, then the entire money will be used. We will not run out of money. Okay, so the comment is long, and then this is the string, which is the by ID. So we'll be informed that it's long 1, long 2, and so on, like depending on the index of grid line, right? So that's the by order. If close is greater than array.get and then grid array and then I position. So if it's less than this one, we did all these things. If it is greater than, then we'll have to close it. We'll have to close the by order that we have already placed, right? But it will not be applied on the first one. It should not be equal to 0, right? So here we'll have to check if there is already an order, which is order array I minus 1. If there's any order already placed in the last position, then we'll have to change it. So let's similar to the buy ID, let's create sell ID, but in this case it would be I minus 1. And simple array dot set, we'll have to change the order array again here to false, and then sell ID comma false. As we have changed it to true here, we'll have to change it to false. And now let's just close it. So strategy dot close, and then ID is string value of sell ID, comment is basically close, right? So this is how we'll be closing it. Now the last thing is let's plot all these things. Okay, I can remove this thing. So the first plot would be, if the value of grids is greater than 0, then I want the first index, which is array dot get grid array, which is the array that we created, and 0th index. This is something that I want. That's the first line basically, right? If it is not greater than 0, then just give me NA. Let's just write colors is equal to colors dot yellow, right? And let's see what is the final is. If I just save it like this, there are some buy and sell orders, and this is the first line. Now we'll have to make a grid, right? Let me just expand it a bit. We have to make a grid, right? Although the trades are getting placed, for visual representations we'll have to make a proper grid. So let's do it for the second one as well. This is the first grid that I have created. The second one, let me just copy and paste it here as well. If the grids is greater than 1, then this will be 1. Other things to be, let's just keep it exactly the same. Let me just save it. We should have 2 lines, and so on. We'll have to like do it for all 15 lines. And in fact, let's just change this to a bit transparent. So it will be color dot new, and the color would be, let's say, color dot yellow only. Transparency should be 70. It should be a bit less transparent. Yeah, this is the better color. Perfect. I have done the same things for all the grid lines till the 15th one. If I just save it like this, it will make grids in all these places. So let me just zoom it a bit. Perfect. So you can see that whenever there is a cross under a crossover of any moving average line or any grids, then there is a buy or sell condition here. The trades are getting closed as well. And let's see what is the result. Let's come to strategy tester. Perfect. So in this case, you can see that the percent profitability is 88.7%, which is good. But again, it is very much limited, because if the prices are in this particular range, then only it will work. The net profit is amazing, 301 trades. Profit factor is also very good. Drawdown is something which should grab our attention. But the average trade is also amazing, which is 0.77%. So we are making around 0.77% in all the trades. So that's a great one. And I think, yeah, we can say that it's a good strategy now that can be considered for further analysis. So guys, if you want to get this particular code, I share my Google Drive access where I have kept this particular code, and there are many more codes that are saved on that particular Google Drive, like my trading bot and some other study materials as well. So how to get an access of my Google Drive? But yeah, before that guys, if you liked even small one thing in this particular video, then just click on the like button, because this is something which is very, very important for content creators like me. Also, as I mentioned in the beginning, there are a lot of videos that are coming on this YouTube channel related to many trading strategies on both Pine Script and Python. So you guys should click on the subscribe button and stay tuned, because a lot of things that's coming on this particular YouTube channel. So now, how to get an access of my Google Drive? Just go to my channel and click on that access to my Google Drive button, and over there just follow some basic steps on how to get the Google Drive access. And you can see that it's very, very affordable. I would say it's less than 1/3 of a coffee price that I'm asking for. And the reason that I'm asking for this small amount of money, because I have hired some interns who are helping me to provide the best possible content to the entire Google Drive community. And I can assure you that you will not be disappointed by even 0.1%. So yes guys, you should try it out. If you guys want me to involve in your personal projects, then you guys should consider seeking out my freelancing services. Just write an email on this particular email address, and I'll try my best to reach out to you as soon as possible. Lastly, in the next video, I will be talking about the best pullback strategy, which will give a very, very good win rate. And I'm not very much concerned about the win rate. It will give 1+% on average trade profitability, which is an amazing number. This is something that is coming in next week. So yes, for that, just stay tuned to my YouTube channel. Thank you so much guys for watching this video till the end. You can click here to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and over there you'll see this entire playlist on Pine Script trading strategies. And over there you'll see the most recent video that is uploaded on my YouTube channel. Down below you can visit my website, which is fpritvik.com. and that's it for this video. I'll see you next week with the best pullback strategy. Till then, peace.